Hi guys, we know well about the different companies as per the Company Act 2013. First one, the public company and private company, public financial institution, one person company or small company, and recently the Company Act 2013 introduced the dormant companies. First of all, the auditing accounts of this company should be done by the auditing firms. For example, PepsiCo company. The audit of PepsiCo company need to be done by the KPMG companies. Or these all the firms are conducting the various accounts auditing of the various companies. So now the question is, the auditing of the big fortune conducted by the auditing firm, who should conduct the audit of the auditing firms? That means audit of the KPMG. There are big firms in the world, you know, KPMG, Deloitte, EY companies, and EXL companies. These are the big auditing firms. Now the major question, who should conduct the audit of the auditing firms? As per the Limited Liability Partnership Rules 2008, under Section 24, Subsection 8 of the LLP Act, the firm, its turnover more than 40 lakhs in any financial years, and whose contribution more than 25 lakhs in any financial years, need to get their accounts audited. And next questions, will they required to get their accounts audited if any LLP fulfill one of the criteria which are specifically mentioned under Section 24, Subsection 8 of the LLP Act 2008? Of course, if they fulfill any one of the criteria under Section 24, Subsection 8 of the LLP rules, they need to get their accounts audited. Next, one more question, are there any other criteria where the firm can be availed from the firm can get the exemption from the audits? Suppose if the firm's turnover less than 40 lakhs and its contribution less than 25 lakhs, no need to get their accounts audited as per the Section 34, Subsection 4 of the LLP Rules 2008. Now one more question, are there any exemptions from the central government in its notifications to get the exemption from the audits? Central government may notify its exemptions for audit from the LLP Act 2008. There are certain companies should not be conduct any kind of audits. They are, turnover is less than 40 lakhs as I discussed earlier, and their contribution is less than 25 lakhs. Now one more question, who conduct the audit of the auditing firms? As per Section 28, Subsection 9 of the LLP Rule 2008, the person or no qualified with the CA in practice. What is the time limited for appointment of the first auditors as per the LLP Act 2008? There is no time limitation for the appointment of the auditors. Suppose the first auditor need to be appointed by the designated partners of auditing firms. Who is the designated partners? Designated partner means who is inducted as the responsible person of the audit firms and the person who has secured the designated partner's identification number from the central governments. There is a system for appointment of the designated partners in the firms. So person, so for example, the minimum two members need to be constituted the audit firms. Maximum should be unlimited. The minimum two members in that, one should be a resident of India, another person from foreign countries. The two members are the responsible officers of the auditing firm. They need to look after the entire governance of the auditing firms. So the first question is, who should appoint the first auditor? That should be appointed by the designated partners who secure the designated partnership identification number from the central governments. Next one, subsequent auditors. Subsequent auditors need to be appointed by the designated partners. And in case, if the designated partners fail to appoint the first auditors, who should appoint the first audit of the companies? In the file of the designated partners, while inducting the person as an auditor of the first auditor of the companies, it should be taken care of by the other partners. And next one is subsequent partners. During the casual vacancy, who should appoint the subsequent partners? The subsequent partners need to be appointed by the other partners in case if the designated partners fail to appoint the subsequent partners. Now, who can fix the remuneration of the first auditors? The first auditor's remuneration need to be fixed by the designated partners. If we fail to fix the remuneration of the first auditors, then it should become under the authority of the other partners. Suppose if the other partners fail to appoint the first auditors within a given time period, then, or suppose if the other partners also fail to appoint the first auditors within a given time period, then any one of the partners can act as an auditor of the firms. Now, one more question I would like to pose here. What is the formalities for resigning the job or resigning the term of office before the expiry of his term? What are the policies need to be followed by the auditors before go for expiry his term of offices? First conditions, if the auditor want to resign his positions before the expiry of his term of office, need to deposit a notice to the Register of the Limited Liability Partners before 14 days of the expiry of his term of office. And that notice should be attached by the statement of circumstances connecting with the his ceasing of offices. And suppose if the existing partners wanted to resign the job before go for inducting him as a subsequent auditor of the companies, you need to inform to the Register of LLPs within 14 days before the expiry of his term of offices. Now, one more question I would like to pose here. Are there any obligation if limited liability partners avail the exemption from audits? Suppose the turnover is less than 40 lakhs and whose contribution is less than 25 lakhs, they need not to get the audit of their accounts, but they need to prepare the financial statement as per the section 24 subsection 8 of the LLP rules 2008. And also that statement should be called as a statement of accounts with solvencies. And they need to prepare one more thing, that is certificate. Certificate means it should be secured by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs. And the certificate should be in the form of 8 and it should be signed by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs along with the statement of accounts and solvencies, which are specifically listed under section, as I said with you people, which are specifically listed under section 28 subsection 11 of the LLP rules 2008. Now, one more question. Suppose, is there any time limitation for the appointment of the first auditors in case of limited liability partnership firms? There is no time limitations, but you need to appoint the first auditors before the end of the financial period, means 30 days before of the financial period of the companies. Today we will discuss something about related to the criteria which are required to get their accounts audited by the auditing firms. And we discussed about the appointment of the first auditors in case of audit firms and appointment of the second auditor in case of audit firms as per the section 28 subsection 9 of the LLP rule 2008. And we were discussing about the exemptions, and also we discussed about the resignation of the auditors. So I would like to close these sessions today. We will discuss something about the company auditor in next sessions. Thank you.